The unauthorized copy, dedicated to successful women everywhere. My name's Sean Booth. Chapter 7. Born 1954, a little black girl that the world would adore. In Mississippi, Orpo was the name of birth, but with so much trouble pronouncing it, they just switched it around a bit. They called her Oprah, Gail Winfrey, Rita since 3. She was a special child, mama left a while, grandma took a ring. She went that extra mile, whatever she could, she did. But they were poor. And at times could only afford dresses made of potato sacks. In the country, till she moved north to her mother in Milwaukee, they said that she had to take her back. Yeah, and in that inner city, she was so out of control. Her mama said that you gotta go. Ran away, got pregnant at 14. Baby died shortly after that in the hospital. Her dark past never talked about, blocked it out, buckled down, turned her whole life around. 17, Miss Black Tennessee, on a student and college bound. Things were looking brighter now. Got a job fast, a radio broadcast, a local station in Tennessee, WVOL. And she did it so well, just a teenager, but soon to be major. Became the first black female on television, and all in Nashville, she was that deal. And with that came awards and accolades, and a job offer in Baltimore she had to take, to be a co-anchor, the 6 o'clock news. But she couldn't cut it, so she got moved. Demoted, demoralized, and dropped in to show people are talking. A blessing in disguise, cause that's how she came to be. It was a training ground, 78 to 83. A big deal in a small town, then she relocated, Chicago bound. Hired by a daytime talk show, last in the ratings, called AM Chicago. It instantly became a hit, renaming it the Oprah Winfrey Show. Then they took a national dethrone. Donahue pushed them down to number 2. They had a little rivalry, see, he was from Chicago too. Plus he was the one that paved the way, a pioneer. He changed the game, he made a tabloid talk show format. Then Oprah came and kicked down the door flat. Revolutionized it, redefined it, syndicated it, and became a giant. And like that, it all changed when she televised the segment on rape and sexual abuse. But right there on air, she confessed to the world as a child she was a victim too. And by then she entered other circles, critically acclaimed for her role in The Color Purple. She interviewed MJ in 93, fourth most watched event on American TV. And from 94, she made a change from traditional talk shows and went against the grain. Focused on self-help, became more of a teacher, a type of church-free spiritual leader. 96 came Oprah's book club, pushing literacy through the books she loves. Over 200 million viewers, and every one of them felt like they really knew her. Her own magazine, her own network, production company, she got her checks first. $1 billion net worth, then enriches lives, self-made, well-paid, extraordinary business mind. And even as a little girl, she knew that she would conquer the world. Not a Coke bottle in a dress, but still America's top model for success. The unauthorized biography of Oprah Winfrey. From poverty to a multi-billion dollar empire, she's become one of the most powerful and influential women in the world. But her legacy isn't just from her success, but also her compassion. Her influence on culture isn't just from her show, but from all the other careers she's also built through a production company.
After deciding to end her show in May 2011,
she's already considered by many analysts to be the greatest pop culture icon of all time. The end. Next chapter, Tupac Shakur.